Cub tickets are available at the Wrigley Field box office or call Ticketmaster at 312-831-CUBS. Wrigley Field, Chicago's place to play.
Wait, now, just wait a minute. All right, you wanted to give me a review of Oscar Peterson?
Yeah.
What? This is Marty Robinson, folks. He said, did you pay to get in, Marty, or did you get in on the... complimentary ticket?
Usually I get one of them ducats,
Marty. Do you? Okay.
Yeah, but I didn't this time because, you know, I get them from WFMT and they're a classical station, so Ravinia's doing jazz the first 6-7 days in June, and I guess they don't rate a jazz ticket, so I had to pay to get in.
I'm going to be there on Sunday, a week from Sunday, with Mel Torme and Shorty Rogers and those guys.
Oh, I remember Shorty Rogers and the Lighthouse All-Stars. Unfortunately, I work Sunday nights. I'm going to try and get there next Friday. But anyhow, Oscar was just wonderful tonight, as was Herb Ellis and Ray Brown.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope the drummer forgives me. I forgot his name, but he was great, too.
Mm-hmm.
And the four of them played for 3 solid hours, so they must have been enjoying themselves as much as everybody in the audience.
No, but it was a gas. Oscar, yeah. You know, I don't know the last time he was here, do you? Was he over at the...
Last time I saw him, Mike, was... I'm sure he's been here since then, but the last time I saw him was at Rick's Cafe, and that's a long time ago.
That's what I'm saying. I think that's the last booking here in town.
Yeah.
I got Nelson and Oscar here with a beautiful recording of his called "Someday My Prince Will Come."
Yeah,
remember that record? Yeah,
know it very well. You know why I thought of you? I was reading a new book, not a new book actually. It came out in 1942. A fella gave it to me who gave me some old records and books. He was moving to North Carolina,
mm-hmm.
And this is called "A Smattering of Ignorance."
Ah.
And it's by Oscar Levant. Do you know it?
Oh, yeah, I know of it, yeah.
Oh, well, I can't tell you anything new about David Raxon, then, because he's got several paragraphs in there, and you already knew all of that.
Well, I wanted to get the book again. I was going to buy one, and I couldn't. I didn't. I was too late getting it, and I want to borrow yours.
I
have to have a library card? Take it out of it.
No, your credit is good with me, Mike. I mean, we go back to about 1957. I think.
Right, Marty. Listen, I got to stop here. We got to, it's time for the news and all that stuff.
I know how it works in radio.
Well, you know how that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, are you still playing the singing capon and the iron butterfly? Or whatever.
No, I haven't.
You're not.
I haven't played him in a long time.
Why we don't want to identify them because this will be a bowling alley tomorrow.
That's right. Okay, Mike. Nice to talk to you.
Thank you, Marty Robinson. I'll see him out at Ravinia then one of
right.
these days.
I hope to run into you.
And then I'll buy the tickets.
I accept.
Marty, talk to you.
Good night.
Good night. Marty Robinson from over there at Channel 11, and I run over time, and Jim Boutette is going to be angry at me. Let me say, this is WGN Chicago. I'm Mike Rapchak, and there's Jim with the news. Jim?